是耶不老师。
Praise the name of Jesus. We are so delighted that you have just watched Kingdom Impact Production. That is right. This is your host, Dr. Kilafu Kali, and we are from Kingdom Apostolic Ministries International here in beautiful Freeport, Grand Bahama. We are exploding. God has truly blessed us. We are live and we are on the air. We are determined to take this gospel of the kingdom. And when this gospel of the kingdom, Jesus said, is preached to the ends of the earth as a witness unto all nations, then the end will come. We believe we have a great responsibility here at Kingdom Apostolic Ministries in preaching, teaching, worshiping, and prophetically declaring this gospel around the world. Lives are being transformed. People are being delivered, healed, and transforming their personal lives. We have so many testimonies. Thank you for watching us. Please tune in to your regular station or on our online platform. All the information will be given to you to contact us, to go on our website, to buy products from our wonderful store and list of teaching. We love you in Jesus' name. We kindly ask you to pray for us, to intercede for us, to stand in the gap with us as we work together as God's people, to touch one life at a time until we reach the world. We have a passion to reach the entire globe. I know we can do it. God has given us the mandate to do it. Thank you again for watching Kingdom Impact Production. Dr. Kilafu Kali, Kingdom Apostolic Ministries here in Freeport. We love you and we bless you in Jesus' mighty name. After we would have sung the song, my wife, Shaleva Kali, Pastor Kali, evangelist, prophetess, will come and deliver what thus says the Lord this morning. Amen?
Amen.
You deserve the glory,
yes,
and the honor. Lord, we lift our hands in worship. As we bless your holy name, you deserve the glory and the honor. Lord, we lift our hands in worship as we bless your holy name. For you are great, you do miracles so great. There is no one else like you. There is no one else like you, for you are great, you do miracles so great, there is no one else like you, there is no one else like you, like you. Stand and welcome Prophetess Pastor Shaleva Kali this morning. Amen.
Glory. Hallelujah. Hey, hallelujah. Jesus Christ is the Lamb of God that takes away your sins this morning. If you confess him as your Lord and Savior this very minute here, I can adore you this morning that you will be the most powerful person in the world. Amen? If you don't believe me, let me prove it to you this morning. Why would you be the most powerful or the most powerful person in the world if you confess and believe that Jesus, hallelujah, Christ is the one that takes away your sins? In the book of Acts 1 and 8, it says, but you will receive power when the Holy Spirit comes upon you, and you will be my witnesses. Amen. And this is Jesus talking in Jerusalem, Bring it fast forwarded to today. You will be my witnesses in Freeport. You will be my witnesses and in Judea and Samaria, in Grand Bahama and in Fort Lauderdale in the Caribbean, and to the ends of the world, and throughout the world. Amen. Mark 16, 17 and 18 says, these signs will accompany those who have believed in my name. They will cast out demons. They will speak with new tongues. They will pick up serpents, and if they drink any deadly poison, it will not hurt them. They will lay hands on the sick, and they will recover. And whose name are we talking about here, saints of God? These signs shall follow them who believe, amen, in my name. Can anyone tell me who is speaking here?
God.
Amen. What's the name of God?
Jesus,
hallelujah. Yes, you got it. You got it. Amen. Jesus said, in my name, once you believe, amen, you shall cast out demons. You shall speak with new tongues. You shall pick up serpents. Amen. If a situation is bothering you and you feel like you're being suffocated, the life is being sucked out of you, amen? In the name of Jesus, amen? You shall break loose from that situation. You shall drink poison and it shall not hurt you, amen? Hallelujah. Give God the glory this morning. Clap your hands unto the Lord. Bless the name of the Lord. Saints of God, casting out demons and praying in your heavenly language, that's not only for pastors and ministers, amen? Anyone who believes that it is for pastors and ministers, amen, in the church, amen, they're not reading the same Bible, amen, because that's not what this Bible says. It says to anyone that believes, amen? John 3 and 36 says, he who believes in the Son has eternal life, but he who does not obey the Son will not see life, but the wrath of God abides on him. Hallelujah. Sometimes when we're wondering, hallelujah, we see people, amen, even if they go and they confess that they are Christian, their life is a wreck, amen. They are mothers and single mothers with several children. Then you notice they have several teenagers. The girls get pregnant. Then you notice the boys are being locked up. Amen. One thing we have to say to them is, once you believe in the Son, you have eternal life. Amen.
Amen.
And he who does not obey. Amen. It means that you're not obeying God. Amen. You're not obeying the Lord and the word of the Lord. So when we see wrath, amen, the wrath of God, amen, abiding with some people, we know that there are some change, there's some mindset, there's some actions that need to be broken and turned away, amen. The word of God says, at the name of Jesus, again, every knee will bow of those who are in heaven and on earth and under the earth, and that every tongue will confess that Jesus Christ is Lord, all to the honor and the glory, amen, of God. Remember my topic for this morning, which says the testimony, hallelujah, the spirit of prophecy, amen, is the testimony of Jesus Christ, amen. When we prophesy, because anyone can prophesy, amen, once you declare a thing and you believe in the Lord, amen, it has to go back to the will of God for your life, amen. Hallelujah. And so in this month of prophecy, I admonish you people of God to believe and prophesy the glory of the Lord in your life. Amen.
Amen.
Repeat after me this morning. I will
prophesy
the glory of God,
in
my life.
I will
prophesy the glory of God, in my life. Amen. Bless the name of the Lord. Turn to the book of Romans, and we're going to read from Romans chapter 10, verses 8 through 10. Amen. Esther, are you with me today? Amen. You're not going to fall asleep on me today. Amen. Give the Lord a hand clap. Romans chapter 10, verses 8 through 10. Hallelujah. Bless the Lord for SJ this morning. Hallelujah. So Romans 10, verses 8 through 10 says, but what does it say? The word is near you. It is in your mouth and in your heart. That is the word of faith which we are preaching. That is the word of faith that I'm preaching to you this morning. Amen.
Amen.
That if you confess with your mouth Jesus as Lord and believe in your heart that God raised him from the dead, you will be saved. Amen.
Amen.
For with the heart of a person believes, you believe with your heart. Amen.
Amen.
Resulting in righteousness. And with the mouth he confesses, which results in salvation.
Amen.
And so once you believe, amen, that Jesus Christ is Lord in your heart,
amen,
this morning, amen, it shall result in righteousness. Amen. Once you confess, hallelujah, bless you, mother. Once you confess, amen, with your mouth that Jesus Christ is Lord, this will result, bless the name of the Lord,
amen,
to salvation.
Yes.
Glory be to the name of the Lord.
Yes.
It's as simple as that. Amen. No one has to be lost. And let me tell you something. If I am down and out, and I see that things aren't going right in my life, and someone come to me and say, hallelujah, accept this Savior and everything will go good in your life. All you have to do is abide by his principles. You think I'm not going to, anyone in their right mind who wouldn't accept and give that a chance, amen, something is wrong with them, amen.
Right.
There is some strongholds and the devil, amen, have a hold on them. Hallelujah, because if somebody is going to cause me to be a light, if somebody is going to, first of all, shine light on me, amen, and then cause me to be a light, amen, why wouldn't I accept that person? If somebody said that they only want surely goodness and mercy to follow me, why would I not go, amen, and why would I not go on that person's side? And all I have to do is just believe and obey, amen,
amen.
And if I have struggles, amen, if I have things that I am battling with and things I cannot tell anybody, amen, once he come into my life, he perfect those things that concern me.
Yes.
Why would you not give him a chance today? Amen.
Yes,
shout Jesus this morning.
Yes. Yes.
Hallelujah. Let me just show you, hallelujah, some Bible prophecies. Amen. As we go on in the same book of John, reading from chapter 1, verses 1 through 18.
Yes.
Amen. And I want you to follow along with me this time. John chapter 1, verses 1 and 18.
Mm-hmm.
And I want you to read along with me. Bless the name of the Lord.
John
chapter 1, verses 1 through 18. Glory be to God. It says, in the beginning was the Word, and the Word was with God.
Amen.
And the Word was God. The same was in the beginning with God. All things were made by him, and without him was
nothing
anything made that was made. In him was life,
yes,
and the life was the light of men, and the light shineth in darkness, and the darkness comprehended not. Amen. Stop there. Amen. Let us look at another Bible passage now. Amen. We're talking about the spirit of prophecy. Amen. Leading back to Jesus this morning.
Yes, ma'am.
Genesis 1. You don't have to turn there. Just leave it where you are in John. Okay?
Mm-hmm.
And just write it down. Genesis 1, 1 through 2 says, in the beginning, God created the heaven and the earth. And the earth was without void and without form and void, sorry. And darkness was upon the face of the deep, and the Spirit of God moved upon the face of the waters. Amen. In the beginning, when the Spirit of God was moving, and when God created the earth, that same Jesus who was the Word, amen, who was with God in the beginning, and who became flesh, he was with God, amen, right,
yeah,
in Genesis. You don't believe me? Let's go ahead and read on. Let's read from 6 to 13. So 1 John 1, 6 to 13 says, there was a man sent from God whose name was John. The same came for a witness, to bear witness of the light, that all men through him might believe. He was not that light, but was sent to bear witness of that light. That was the true light, which lighteth every man that cometh into the world. He was in the world, and the world was made by him, and the world knew him not. He came unto his own, and his own received him not.
But as many as received him, to them gave the power, again, you received power to become the sons of God, even to them that believe on his name, which were born not of blood, nor of the will of flesh, nor of the will of man, but of God. Yeah. Hallelujah. I say again to you, imagine someone who would give you another chance. Yes. Amen. Yes. Isn't God good this morning? Yes, shout, Lord, you are good.
Lord, you are good.
Lord, you are good.
Lord, you are good.
Hallelujah. How many persons do you know throughout history, amen, that came and said that they are Lord, amen, and their own, amen, their own did not receive them. Only one person we can think of, amen, who came and who was in the Israel, amen, and who was a part of the Israelites, and they didn't receive him, amen.
Amen.
Only one person that we can think of. Only one person gave power. Only one person cast out demons.
Yes, Lord.
And so on, and I'm running a little bit ahead of myself. That's but there right. is nobody else, amen, who we know in history where somebody came before him and bear witness of him. Can you think of anybody else? Many persons say that they are God. There are many religions. But how many persons had someone come before them to bear witness? Okay. Amen. And to be alive. Amen.
Amen.
Glory be to God. Now the book of Malachi, to back this up. Amen. And you don't have to turn there again. Malachi 3 verses 1 through 5 says, behold, hallelujah, I will send my messenger, and he shall prepare the way before me.
Yes.
Amen. This is the Lord speaking now.
Yes.
And the Lord whom ye seek shall suddenly come to his temple, even the messenger of the covenant whom ye delight in. Behold, he shall come, saith the Lord of hosts. But who may abide the day of his coming? And who shall stand when he appeareth? For he is like a refiner's fire. Amen. And like fuller's soap. And he shall sit at a refiner and purifier, as a refiner and purifier of silver. Amen. Yes. How many of you can bear witness that the Lord purified you?
Amen.
And you came out as silver and gold. Hallelujah. You're looking at a witness right here. Amen.
Yes.
Hallelujah. And he shall purify the sons of Levi, and shall purge them as gold and silver, and they may offer unto the Lord an offering in righteousness. Then shall the offering of Judah and Jerusalem be pleasant unto the Lord, as in the days of the Lord, and as the former years.
Yes.
And I will come near to you to judgment. Amen.
Amen.
You remember, hallelujah, John said, repent, because the kingdom of Lord is at hand. Amen?
Amen.
Hallelujah. This is where the judgment begins, because he already started declaring, amen, that the kingdom of God was coming. So if you don't want to be judged, amen, then you have to line up.
Yes.
Amen. In this season.
Amen.
And I will be a swift witness against the sorcerers. Amen. And adult, and against the adulterers, and against false swearers, and against those that oppose the hireling.
Yes.
In his wages, the widow and the fatherless, and that turn aside the stranger from his right, and fear not me, said the Lord of hosts. Amen. This is the Lord speaking to back up that passage. Amen. In 1 John 6:13. When the Lord came, Jesus spoke, he said that he came for the widowed. He came for those who are broken. Amen.
Amen.
It is written, and there are plenty of examples. Hallelujah. Where? Amen. Those who are sorcerers, amen. He dealt with sorcerers.
Yes.
Even his servants, the Apostle Paul, amen. Those who were sorcerers. The young girl who was using divination to make money for her masters, amen. They cast the demon out.
Yes.
Hallelujah. The lady who was an adulterer, amen. The woman at the well, amen. All of these people. Jesus came. That was his word. Hallelujah. Being fulfilled. Amen. You see where the Bible lines up, people of God.
Yeah.
The Bible doesn't contradict itself. Amen. You have to study to show yourself approved. Amen.
Amen.
Only Jesus, amen, that we know of has done this. Amen.
Yes.
Any other person who say whatever, there is nothing to back up it. It's just that one person word and the followers. But can they talk about miracles? Can they talk about blind eyes being opened in the name of Jesus? Yes, now I'm not gonna lead you to think that they are not those who use, amen, demonic powers to cause these things to happen, amen. But those people who use demonic powers, they don't restore adulterers, amen.
No.
They don't do anything for widows. They don't care. They don't do anything, amen, that is good. Those who are fatherless, they don't be their father and give them needs, amen.
Yeah.
So you see where the difference is. Bless the name of the Lord.
Yes.
Let us go now to John, 1 John. We're going to read 14 through 18. It says, "And the Word was made flesh and dwelt among us, and we beheld his glory, the glory as of the only begotten of the Father, full of grace and truth. John bare witness of him,"
amen,
"amen, and cried, saying, this was he of whom I spoke.
Yes.
He that cometh after me is preferred before me," amen,
amen,
"for he was before me. And of his fullness have all we received, and grace for grace. For the law was given by Moses, but grace and truth came by Jesus Christ." Amen?
Amen.
This grace, amen, is the grace that gives each and every one of us another chance. Amen.
Yes.
It has given us a chance for those of us who are in here. For those of you who are in your struggles and circumstances. Amen. It is only him who leads us in truth,
yes,
and grace by giving us another,
amen,
chance.
Yes.
Amen. "No man had seen God at any time. The only begotten Son, which is in the bosom of the Father, he had declared him."
Yes.
Amen.
Amen.
Stop there. Psalms 84, 11 and 12 says, "For the Lord God is a sun and shield. The Lord will give grace and glory." Amen.
Yes.
This is David now. This is all the way from the Old Testament. "No good thing will he withhold from them that walk uprightly." Amen.
Amen.
"O Lord of hosts, blessed is the man that trusted in thee." Amen.
Yes.
That's a word there for you to clap and give God the glory,
amen,
this morning there. Amen. That's one word. If you can hold on just to this word alone,
oh,
and believe, you can be blessed from this scripture. You hear what it says? "O Lord of hosts, blessed is the man that trusted in thee." If you continue to declare out of your mouth, "Lord, I trust in you." Amen. You have to be led by him. He has to perfect everything, amen, that concern you. He has to be a shield for you, amen.
Amen.
He shall withhold nothing good, hallelujah, from you, because that's his word.
Amen.
Remember, the word of God says, his word shall not come back to him void. His word is life, amen.
Amen.
His word is quick and living and active, sharper than any two-edged sword. The word of God breaks rocks into pieces like hammer. Amen. That's why the word of God says the weapons of our warfare are not carnal, but mighty through God for the pulling down of stronghold. Do you have stronghold in your life today? Use the word of God, people of God. Amen.
Amen.
Let the word of God break that rock. Break that stronghold into pieces. Amen. Hallelujah.
Amen.
Glory be to the God.
Amen.
And so as we are observing the birth of our Lord in this season, amen, may you also celebrate life abundantly.
Yes.
Amen. I declare that you celebrate prosperity,
yes,
and good health, amen, as your soul prosper. Amen. When we talk about sin and amen, sin is an immoral act that is considered as a transgression, amen, against God. Amen. But because of our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ, who wants us to prosper,
yes,
who wants us to be in good health,
yes,
who wants us to have abundant life.
Yes.
Amen. He came and died so we wouldn't be ashamed, so we wouldn't be in struggles, so we wouldn't have lack. Amen.
Right.
Hallelujah. It is,
amen,
like, amen, for example, getting locked up. I don't think any one of us in here would have been locked up, but you, even those on TV, would have heard of somebody who was locked up. Amen. You was locked up, but your parents came and bailed you out. Amen.
Yes.
That's what it is. That's what God wants to do for you.
Yes.
Hallelujah today. Amen. It is like for you little ones that are here,
mm-hmm,
for SJ. I know it ain't you because you will behave, SJ. Your parents tell you not to touch the candy jar. Amen. But you still climb up.
Yes.
Amen. And you try to get the candy out of the candy jar, and it falls and it bursts your forehead. Amen. Your parents might punish you, but they would still hush you and run to the hospital with you and, you know, make sure you get medical attention. Amen?
Amen.
This is the same thing, amen, that Jesus wants to do for us. Amen. In other words, he makes everything okay.
Amen,
amen for us. Amen.
Yes.
The word of God again in Psalms 138 and 8 says, he perfects everything that concerns you. Amen. So repeat after me, Lord.
Lord,
you perfect,
Lord, you perfect
everything,
everything
that concerns me. Glory be to God. Hallelujah.
Amen.
People of God, those of you who are listening on television, he came to give you rest. He came that you may have life more abundantly. Jesus wants to do the same thing for you today. Amen.
Amen.
The word of God says in Romans 12, 1 through 6, that I beseech you, therefore, brethren, by the mercies of God, that he present your bodies a living sacrifice, holy, acceptable unto God, which is your reasonable service.
Yes.
And be not conformed to this world, but be transformed by the renewing of your mind, that he may prove what is that good and acceptable and perfect will of God.
Yes.
For I say, through the grace given unto me, to every man that is among you, not to think of himself more highly than he ought to think, but to think soberly, according as God has dealt to every man the measure of his faith. There is that word faith again. For as we have many members in one body, and all members have not the same office, so we bring many, are one body in Christ, and everyone members one of another. Amen?
Amen.
Having then gifts differing according to the grace that is given to us, whether prophecy, let us prophesy according to the proportion of faith. Amen?
Amen.
This is not just for ministers as they prophesy unto you. Amen?
Amen.
As I speak prophetically this morning, sometimes thinking highly of yourself is knowing that you are a liar and somebody tell you that you're a liar and you don't want to accept it. You're like, no, that's not true. That's also thinking highly of yourself. You think that you're perfect, amen. Somebody tell you that, you know, they notice that you thief something and you always do it, or you always take news from one person, you told news, whatever, and someone called you out on it and you're like, no, and then you cause fuss and a fight. Amen.
Yeah.
That is also being prideful and thinking highly of yourself, even as members, amen, of the body of Christ. Amen.
Amen.
And sometimes when we talk about prophecy, it's not only in prophesying, amen, as I speak prophetically this morning, prophesying as though ministers would come and give you a word of God or a knowledge of God. Sometimes we prophesy and say things that are doesn't line up to the word of God.
Amen.
We tell our children, you're dumb and stupid.
Mm-hmm.
We tell ourselves, man, I can't do this. Amen.
Right.
You say, oh, this ain't nothing happening in Freeport.
Yeah.
Ain't nothing happening for this one or for that one. Amen. Oh, I can't read the Bible. Oh, praying ain't for me. Or, oh, going to church ain't for me. Or, you know what, I can't come to church because I need to get my life together. That is also thinking highly of yourself. Amen. That means you think you're right in what you're doing. You're lifting up yourself and you want to stay that way. Amen.
Yes.
But I want to remind you today that life and death is in the tongue. Amen. You also have to speak and prophesy the word of God. Amen.
Yeah.
You also have to declare things that lines up with the word of God. Amen.
Yes.
And that's why, amen, you have to know about, you have to know who the enemy is. Amen.
Amen.
A lot of people don't think that they have enemies. They just living and just going on and things are happening to them, and sometimes they have the ability to change it, amen, but and speak to the situation, but they stay and they dwell in it. But what the word of God says, without knowledge, amen, my people
perish.
Amen. And so enemies, you do have enemies. If God has enemies and you declare that you're a child of God, you have enemies, okay? I might as well tell you. Amen. The word of God says, though, that when your ways please the Lord, your enemies, amen, shall be at peace with you. Amen. So they may not necessarily do things, amen, to attack you or whatever, or even demons. But sometimes you have to know being connected to an apostolic house.
Yes.
And also the call on your life. People like us who cast out demons and who minister those who are sick, amen, for them to heal, but especially cast out demons. You know the enemy ain't gonna like us, eh? You know that all kind of spirits, all kind of stuff is gonna be coming after us, but we know the word of God and we stand on that, amen?
Amen.
But just to give you an example for you to see this morning, selfishness, anger, hatred, lack, confusion, all of those are demonic spirits, amen? Just as how you have the spirit, amen, the fruit of the spirit, love, joy, peace, and so on. Though when you have the spirit of God, you will illustrate those or demonstrate those fruits, amen? When you have the spirit of Satan, because remember the word of God says he brought us out of darkness into a marvelous light. Amen. Either you're in the kingdom of light,
yes,
or you're in the kingdom of darkness.
Amen.
So if you don't possess joy, peace, love, and what have you, amen, that means that you, the spirit, the strong and ruling spirit, is demonic in you, and which is of Satan, amen. So you will be selfish, you will be angry, you will hate, you will have unforgiveness, you will have lack in your life, there will always be confusion among you, amen. And this is just to name a few. Basically, everything opposite from what the fruit of the Spirit, the Holy Spirit of God, yes, Mother, manifests in you. Amen?
That's how that goes.
So sometimes these demonic forces, they operate in our lives, though, because we give them legal authority. Amen? If we don't confess Jesus as Lord, and if our works and our actions, our words don't line up to the will of God, then we give them legal authority. Amen. It's like coming to church, singing on the praise team, dancing, shouting, preaching, but you don't pay your tithes. Or when you sing on the praise team today, you go home and you go home to your lover. You two are not married, or you on the praise team and you have someone, husband, amen, who is by you through the week or whatever. Amen. So you give them legal authority to operate in your life. Amen. So when people around us act a certain way, the question that you should ask is their action giving glory to God?
Right.
Amen. Even for yourself, when you do things from today on, amen, as we're prophetically speaking, does my actions give glory to God?
Okay.
Amen. The Bible speaks about people who are full of evil. Amen. In Romans 3, from 12 to 14, amen, and you don't have to turn there. It says, just write it down, it says, all have turned aside. Together they have become useless. There is none who does good. There is not even one. Their throat is an open grave. With their tongues they will keep deceiving. The poison of asp is under their lips, whose mouth is full of cursing and bitterness, amen?
Amen.
Psalms 56:6 says, they conspire, they lurk, they watch my step, hoping to take my life. For my enemies speak against me, and they that lay wait for my soul take counsel together. Amen? Sometimes you wonder why people around you who usually aren't friends, all of a sudden you see them friends talking and laughing. And then when you enter into the room, everybody goes quiet. Amen? Amen. If you're prophetic, you will see and know exactly what's going on. Amen?
Yes.
Amen.
Are there those who do this to you? Amen? And or do you do it to anyone? Amen? Because it can be on both sides. Sometimes us as people of God, we need to do things to line up. Amen? Amen. In accordance to the word of God. But I pray that it is not you today. Amen?
Amen.
But I declare over everyone under the sound of my voice today. Amen. This day, the word of God that says, he who loved to pronounce a curse, may it come back on him.
Yes.
He found no pleasure in blessing. Amen. You find no pleasure in the Lord blessing me.
No.
They find no pleasure in the Lord blessing you. May it be far from them.
Yes.
Amen. You ought to do unto others as you would have them do unto you. Amen. Can I get a witness?
Yes.
He wore cursing as his garments. Amen. Some people, they just go around and they curse everything. What other people do? If they see you rising and shining, oh, I don't know about that. Oh, that person isn't as good as people say. Oh, they just lotioning, or they just showing favoritism. Or, oh, she's sleeping the boss to get there. Or, oh, she just showing off and trying to friend up with the boss because of, amen, because of promotion. Whatever the situation is, amen. The word of God says he wore cursing as his garment, and enter into his body like water, into his bones like oil. When you go around and curse other people, amen, you know water soak into your body, amen, through your skin. When your skin is dry and you put oil on it, it absorbs into your skin. So if you want to go and curse someone, that is going to absorb into your skin and into your bones. Amen. That's not my word. That is the word of God. Amen. May it be like a cloak wrapped about him, like a belt tied forever around him. May this be the Lord's payment to our accusers today, to those who speak evil of us. Amen?
Amen.
Hallelujah. I declare that over each and every one of us today. Don't think that I am cursing, hallelujah, anyone, people of God. I am simply standing on the word of God. The word of God says, his plans is for me to prosper. So if I'm prospering, why are you going to hate, amen, on me because I'm prospering? And furthermore, the word of God says to hate someone, you're just like a murderer. So you may not pick up a knife or a gun and come after me. But if you hate me, amen, you are a murderer. Amen.
Yes.
Hallelujah. The word of God says he calls me out of darkness into a marvelous light. The word of God said that he calls us from our mother's womb, amen. He set us forth for such a time as this, amen. The word of God says, touch not my anointing and do my prophets no harm. The word of God says, he will bless those that bless me. Amen. He will bless those that bless you. He will curse those that curse you. He contends with those that contends with us. He curses those that curse us. Amen. Hallelujah. Yeah. He fight against those who fight against us. He fights. Amen. Hallelujah. That's how powerful the Lord is. The Lord will do anything. Amen.
Yeah.
Once God get a hold on you. Amen. Because the Lord know you have a purpose. And know that when you step out into the world and answer to your calling, how many people you can save and touch. You really think that the Lord is going to allow anybody to hurt and harm you? Seriously? No, it cannot happen. Give the Lord a hand clap. Never, 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 never.
Amen.
The only way that will happen is if you fulfill, amen, your purpose in God. It cannot happen. Amen.
Amen.
Hallelujah. And when I speak this morning, I'm not necessarily speaking to individuals, people of God. Amen. Like I said, they are spirits that operate, amen, and people around them. Some have the spirit of God, some have the spirits of the devil. Amen. But every power that is ordained, every power that there is on earth, it has been ordained by God. Amen. And if the Lord God is in me, I have the power to speak and render those spirits of the devil powerless. Amen.
Amen.
Hallelujah. Because all of them are at Jesus' feet. Amen. Glory be to the name of the Lord. Hallelujah. So for those who are going through, amen, one thing I would like to say to you, amen. Sometimes when you're going through, you're not only being tested like Abraham, or it's not just people picking on you. Amen.
Amen.
When Job was, amen, tested by God. Amen. Job, one of the things that Job was doing, and a lot of people don't pick up on it.
Yes.
Job was idolizing his children.
Whoa.
Amen. If you read the word of God carefully, you can miss it. But remember, Job was faithful to God and observing him. He himself was doing everything right. Amen. But he would also very often, He would give sacrifices for his children, you know, just in case they are doing something, whatever, he making sure if they're messing up, if they do something, because you don't know everything what your children do, but he is giving sacrifices, amen, just so that his children can be saved.
Amen.
Amen.
That's right.
He loved them so much. Amen. He want to make sure if anything happened, they're in right standing with God.
Yes.
Amen.
Amen.
But now we don't have to do animal sacrifices anymore. Amen. As the word of God says earlier, we ought to present our bodies as living sacrifices. Amen. And so Jesus paid the ultimate price for us. Amen. So, and there is no other name of which we can be saved.
Yes.
You know what that means? I say that to say, nowadays, because Jesus, amen, paid the sacrifice for us, we cannot sacrifice for our children.
Yeah.
Like what Job did. We can't do that no more and think our children are going to make it to heaven. Amen.
No.
Is that the word of God?
Yes, it is.
Grammy or mommy, they can't save you. Papa or daddy, amen. They cannot offer offering or anything and save you, amen. The only thing they can do is just pray that the Lord touch you and that you're in obedience, amen, to the word of God. Amen.
Amen.
In order for your children to be saved, you have to live a life that is pleasing. Amen. Unto God. Amen. In order for me and my friends and my family to be saved, I have to live a life that is pleasing to God. Amen. Where they recognize the God in me and they want to come and accept and serve this God.
Yes.
Amen. The word of God says, if I be lifted up, that is Jesus, I will draw all men unto me. So if I continue to lift up the name of Jesus, men, amen, my family, my children, my friends shall be drawn unto Jesus. Amen.
Amen.
And so in this season, people of God, we have to stop gossiping. Amen.
That's
we have to stop upholding idle talk.
Right.
We have to flee from bad company.
Oh,
we have to flee from compromising.
Right.
We have to seek after the Lord and where the Lord wants to take us and what he wants us to do in this season. We have to stop biting, amen.
Right.
We have to stop using our mouth as open grave unto other people. Hallelujah. Because if you say you serve Jesus, there is no way people could be drawn to serve Jesus. Hallelujah.
Right.
If you are doing these things, amen.
Yes.
If someone is wrong, hallelujah, in this season and out of the will of God, hallelujah, you can't make them feel as though they are right, amen.
Yeah.
In this season, if your child steals, amen, and brings stolen goods to you, or if your child steals and bring home grocery from stolen money, amen, you're not showing, amen, that you demonstrating your sense of God, hallelujah, in your life, amen.
Right.
If your daughter or your son have three baby mothers, amen, and because you like this one more than the next one, and this one have two babies, and you dressing up, and you going to church and as for the christening as mother, and all of that, you're not showing your stance for God, amen.
No.
If you are showing off your daughter, amen, who was on the first, the second, the third boyfriend, because your daughter have boyfriend and this other one, daughter don't have boyfriend, you're not showing your stance, amen, for God. You should be teaching them, hallelujah, about Jesus. You should be telling them about salvation.
Amen.
You should be leading them,
God,
hallelujah, to Christ. You should tell them, yeah, you mess up when they do the first one, but you have to go back to God.
Yeah.
I will love you and I will cover you, because love covers a multitude of sin. But honey, you have to get it right, amen?
Yeah.
In Jesus' name, even your son, you have to tell them, amen? You can't afford. First of all, you don't know some of these women. They have Jezebel spirits, amen.
Oh.
Their families are into things that is not of God.
Yeah.
You have to train them.
Yeah.
You have to let them know that it is not righteous, amen, to go and put your seed all over the place.
Right.
Many men are being locked up innocently because they get the girl pregnant and because they don't want to be with them because of their lifestyle or so, amen. Every minute they have to go to court and this and that, even when they help and do other things for the child, amen. The woman do all kind of things to spite them. Hallelujah, in the name of Jesus. And so you have to stand up for your children. Hallelujah, amen. Glory be to the name of the Lord. Hallelujah. And if you go in front of your children, hallelujah, and you keep talking to them about God, if you keep talking to your family about Jesus, amen, hallelujah, and they refuse, especially for you mothers out there, go and go on your face and you repent, amen, yes, for all the things that you did and you didn't do that caused them to be out of, yes, the will of God. Because sometimes, hallelujah, mm-hmm, as apostles say, amen, when the children ought to go to church even on Sunday, you say, oh no, they must stay home or rest today, amen, when they ought to participate in Sunday school. No, when people want to teach them about the Bible, oh no, just leave them. They will learn in time. I'll ease them into it. Amen. When somebody want to pray for your child, amen, or telling your child the right thing to do, amen, yes, you step and say, don't touch my child. Oh, my child ain't going to this church because this woman is going to that church and they just do this and they just do that. You repent, amen, before the Lord for yourself, for the things that you did to cause, amen, the sins that you caused to fall upon your child and for them, hallelujah, to be away from God. The word of God says to train up a child, amen, in the way of the Lord, and when he is old, amen, he shall not depart. Now, some of us may do a little going to church and Sunday school and whatever, but it's more than that. You have to read and study the Bible, amen, with your child. Amen. The Jews, I think by the age of five, the children, by the age of five, they know the whole five books of the Bible. They memorize that. Amen. Now, they're no different from us. If they can do that, why can't we do that? That's training up your child, hallelujah, in the way of the Lord. Amen. And so go before the Lord and repent, amen, and whatever the Lord tells you to do, ask him for his direction and then seek a different approach and get your family saved today, amen. Yeah. We ought to be honest, hallelujah, yes, give the Lord a hand clap.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah, we ought to be honest with ourselves, amen, yes, when we do things, when we're at fault, amen. Sometimes we say privately to ourselves, if I had known, only known, amen. But the word of God says to confess your sins one to another. Amen?
Yeah.
You want to confess your sins one to another. Am I in good timing, Apostle?
Yes, go ahead.
Amen. Amen. If you like to drink and you know that drinking causes you to feel like you want pleasure every time and you don't think clearly, then don't do it. Amen? If you know that every time you go by that person, one thing leads to another, amen, then don't go by that person. If you think, amen, that you, if you know that you like to spend money, then don't go out with money on you, amen.
Right.
Whatever you did today, people of God, whatever it is that you did, just repent, amen.
Amen.
Moving forward prophetically and standing on the word of God. Everybody have to be clear, amen, amen, and their spirit have to worship God today in truth, amen.
Yes.
Apostle taught us this principle in here, and I just want to do it with you today. And even for those of you who are on television, just repeat after me, amen.
Amen.
Lord.
Lord.
I did it.
I did it.
Now say what you did, but don't say it loud for everybody to hear. Just take a minute, and some things that you did that is not of God, whatever he shows you, whatever he brings to your attention, whether good or bad, just repent. Just think of it and just repent of it, whatever it is. Whatever it is, if you told a lie, children, if you take something from mommy that you wasn't supposed to take, whatever it is, if you was mad at somebody for years and you still have them on your heart, whatever it is, repent of it this morning. Good and bad, sexual immorality, repent of it. Mm. Whatever it is, indecent act that is against the will of God, hatred, anger, jealousy, covetousness, just repent. Put it on your mind, whatever the Lord is showing you. Amen. Even on TV land, whatever the Lord is showing you, just repent of it. Amen.
Amen.
Now I want you to say it again. Lord.
Lord.
I did it.
I did it.
I repent.
I repent.
Lord.
Lord.
I did it.
I did it.
I repent.
I repent.
I want you to say it like you mean it this morning. Come on now, Lord.
Lord.
I did it.
I did it.
I repent.
I repent.
Amen. I want to declare over you that whoever is in God, amen, is a new creature. Amen. once you would have repented and you would have confessed of those things, amen, you are forgiven. In Jesus' name, amen.
Amen.
The word of God says in 1 Peter 1 and 6, 6 through 8, concerning struggles and trials, when you are in God, in this you greatly rejoice, even though now for a little while, if necessary, you have been distressed by various trials, especially if it's not your fault or it directly that you did. So that the proof of your faith,
yes,
being more precious than gold, which is perishable, even though tested by fire, may be found to result in praise and glory and honor at the revelation of Jesus Christ. Mm-hmm. Remember, the spirit of prophecy is the testimony of Jesus. Amen?
Amen.
And though you have not seen him, you love him. And though you do not see him now, but believe in him, you greatly rejoice with joy and with joy inexpressible and full of glory. There's a song that goes with this and say, it is joy unspeakable and full of glory. Amen. Can you imagine having joy unspeakable and you're full of the glory,
yeah,
of God? The glory is the person, amen, the essence, the character of God, amen, where everything is perfect, amen. Yet through trials, no money, you feel like you don't have no blessing, no appreciation, you have lack or bad health, amen? Though they plot evil against you and devise evil and wicked scheme, amen? The word of God says that they cannot succeed, amen? Be like Joseph in Genesis, amen, chapter 50, verses 19 and 20. Joseph said to them, which was his brother, do not be afraid, for I am in God's place, amen? When these circumstances and trials arise, you just go before God and be honest and you repent before him. Amen. You confess and repent. And if it's the enemy, you just tell the enemy, you can do whatever you want. Amen. And I'm not saying that you don't necessarily have to say it to people. Amen. You just declare it in the atmosphere and you speak unto those spirits.
Yeah.
You do whatever you want to do because I am in God's place. Amen. And you say it with that authority. Amen. He said, as for you, you meant evil against me. Amen. Sometimes people mean evil against you. Amen. But God meant it for good in order to bring about this result. Amen. To preserve many people. Hallelujah. Alive. Let me tell you, people of God, from a personal testimony. I promised the Lord and I made some promises to him and the Lord spoke to me,
yes,
amen, concerning my life and my destiny. I prayed and fasted for my husband before I even know. I went on a fast, amen, and I said to the Lord, I say, Lord, on this fast, I wrote a few things down and I said, one of the main things is, whoever my husband is, make a way out of no way for him to come and reveal himself, hallelujah, unto me. And by the seventh day when that fast ended, amen, I was sick, amen, and the man of God came and presented, hallelujah, himself unto me, amen, and not even... And not even in the flesh, amen. He approached me, amen, by the will of God. Because of the healing anointing that he had on him. Amen. He invited me to a healing service. Amen. They prayed for me. They touched my neck from, amen, from thyroid and palpitation. And I've never, amen, had that problem again, which was a few years ago. Amen. He preached the word and pushed me, hallelujah, into the things of God. And sometime even in that, among other things, I was in the flesh and I would get upset and be mad. And sometimes I had to study, amen, and I wanted to leave the presence of God, amen, while the service is going on. I want to rush home, amen, to my study. And, you know, he would say, wait in the presence of the Lord. And I would be so mad and really upset, you know, operating in the flesh, hallelujah. But through it all, amen, I would wonder, I know that's what the Lord told me, but he presented himself as an honorable vessel, amen, of God unto me, leading me in the things of God. Many times I wonder, Lord, is this what you say? What is supposed to line up? And the Lord said, you make a decision, amen. Where you are, you're growing, amen. If you should step out of that, Amen. You're not going to be where you're supposed to be because I have you. Amen. Where you ought to be. And so, people of God, I kept my eyes on Christ. Amen. Sometime when I was tired and sometime when I was dismayed or discouraged or disappointed. Hallelujah. I looked to God. I learned how to worship. I would never open my mouth by myself to sing worship. I learned how to worship. I learned how to preach. Amen. I learned how to receive the blessing. Amen. Of God. I know how to be unselfish. Amen. And pour out and give back all that the Lord has given me into. Amen. People. Amen. My books have reached several different countries and I have people calling and saying, what a blessing. Amen. My book. Hallelujah has been to them, and it's all through obedience and making your life a living sacrifice. Amen. And so I stand before you speaking prophetically. Hallelujah today to tell you, amen, once you trust in the Lord and once you wait on him, hallelujah, you get your reward. And when the Lord rewards you, people of God, it could be great or small. I learned to settle for the small things. Sometimes I wasn't even looking at husband or whatever. I just was grateful for the small things that the Lord was doing. So when the time came, hallelujah, I was even surprised and caught off guard. But to God be the glory. Amen. What the Lord do is well done. Amen. So I want you to be encouraged. Amen. Once you are filled with the Holy Spirit and allow the Lord to lead you, amen, you have power to tread upon serpents and scorpions. Amen. You have the power to resist the devil and he shall flee from you. Amen. Even if all kind of spirit come to attack you. Amen. The word of God says 1,000 shall come on your right and 10,000 at your left, but they shall not, hallelujah, come nigh you. Amen. So I want you to be encouraged, hallelujah, as the Lord is moving today. I know the Lord would have ministered to each and every one of you today in a very special way. And before I go, I just want you to lift your hands unto the Lord this
hallelujah.
Morning.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Thank you, Jesus.
Father, amen. We surrender all to you.
Yes.
Father, we give you all the praise, the glory, and the honor. Father, we declare that it is not us who live, but it is you who live in us, O God. Father, may your Holy Spirit fall afresh upon us, O God. Send your anointing, O God, upon us to continue to destroy every yoke. Father, I speak over everyone under the sound of my voice. Hallelujah, that they will come up in you. Lord God, just as you have done it for me, you are no respecter of person, O God. Let their righteousness which is in you go before them, and your glory be their reward, O God, as you take them from glory to glory. I speak and declare now, O God, that their faith be activated in the name of Jesus. I declare that their belief be activated,
hallelujah.
O God, in the name of Jesus, that they are in you and they are marked with the mark of Christ, and nothing is impossible for them this morning, O God. And even as I leave, hallelujah, from your place, and thank you for allowing me to declare
hallelujah.
Your word unto them, Lord God. May your fire rest and remain upon them. Oh, Father, in the name of Jesus, let your spirit, your power manifest in their lives and in their homes. Even now, oh God, like never before, may they continue to declare the word of the Lord from even when they rise early in the morning,
yes.
Oh God, and everything that concerning them.
Yes.
May your Spirit just rest upon them and keep them, Lord. In Jesus' precious and holy name, we give you glory and honor, for thine
hallelujah.
Is the kingdom, the power, and the glory forever and ever. Let the people of God shout,
amen.
Hallelujah. Bless the name of the Lord.
We are so delighted that you took the time with your family and your loved one to tune into this broadcast, Kingdom Impact Production. We have been doing all we could to get this gospel of the kingdom out. I pray that this message really transform your heart, that you would spend some time today reflecting on it. You will go to your Bible and go through and study what was taught and really implement those things. The Lord has a great purpose for your life. We are standing with you here at Kingdom Apostolic Ministries. We request your prayer, your financial support. Please visit us on our website. Please see us on the various mediums that will come up on this site. And follow us. I would love to hear from you. Please email, call, Skype me. all the methods you can. Please let us know that you're with us praying for us, and be a blessing if you can. Please bless us with any donation. No donation is too big or too small. Again, God bless you. We look forward to you joining us again for another presentation. Amen.